Hello everyone, welcome back to the Rasa Masterclass. In this episode, you will learn what are the contextual AI assistants and how they differ from other types of assistants. You will also learn what is Rasa and how different components of the framework allow you to build your best conversational AI. And last but not least, you will learn how to get started with building your own conversational AI assistants using Rasa tools. So let's dive right in. So what are the conversational AI assistants and how they differ from other types of assistants? To answer this question, let's take a look at how conversational AI assistants evolved over time. At Rasa, when we talk about the evolution of conversational AI, we use the concept of five levels of assistants. Level 1, notification assistants. It's very likely that you have already interacted with these assistants on your phone or on your laptop. They send you simple notifications, but they show up as text on a messaging app like WhatsApp. Level 2, FAQ assistants, the most common type of assistants at the moment. They allow the users to ask simple questions and get the answers, which is a slight improvement to commonly used FAQ pages with a search bar. The only difference is that FAQ assistants are sometimes enhanced with one or two follow-up questions. Until this day, the industry standard to build FAQ assistants is using a set of rules or a state machine. It makes it very easy to build these assistants, but at the same time, it makes them very prone to mistakes when the conversation takes a different turn from what is enforced by defined rules. Level 3, contextual AI assistants. If you think about how humans talk to each other, you will probably agree that the context matters. What the user said before, when, where, and how they said it should influence how the conversation goes. Considering the context also means being capable of understanding and responding to different and unexpected user inputs. This is how contextual AI assistants differ from FAQ and notification assistants. They consider the context of what has been said before, gracefully handle unexpected dialogue turns, drive the conversation when the user drifts from the regular conversation path, and improve over time. Contextual AI assistants are a big step further from FAQ and notification assistants, and the best thing is that you can already build them using Rasa tools. So if contextual AI assistants is where we are right now, what can we expect from the future? Well, we can expect level 4 personalized AI assistants. Just like you would expect from the human that gets to know you better over time, AI assistants will likely do the same. For example, AI assistants will learn when it is the best time to approach you based on the context and your habits. Personalized AI assistants will remember your preferences and provide you the ultimate personalized interface. Eventually, we will get to level 5, autonomous organizations of assistants. There will be groups of assistants that will know every customer personally and will take over large parts of companies' operations, from lead generation to marketing, HR, sales, or even finance. It's a huge leap that will take many years to happen, but it's a vision that we see as a reality. In Rasa Masterclass, we will be focusing on building level 3, contextual AI assistants. So how Rasa enables developers to go beyond simple FAQ assistants? The answer is in Rasa's machine learning-based approach on learning from real conversational data. To understand this better, let's first take a look at what Rasa is and how all of the components work together. Rasa is an open-source machine learning framework for building chat and voice contextual AI assistants. It consists of two main components, natural language understanding and dialogue management. Natural language understanding, or in other words, NLU, is a so-called ear of your assistant, which enables your assistant to understand what is being said. It takes inputs in a simple, unstructured human language and extracts structured data in a form of intents and entities. Intents can be understood as labels that are attached to each user input based on the overall goal of user's message. For example, a user input hello may have an intent greet, because the overall meaning of this input is a greeting. Entities are pieces of information that an assistant may need in a certain context. For example, a message, "My name is Juste," has my name in it. An assistant should be able to extract my name and remember it throughout the conversation to keep the interaction natural. This is achieved by training a named entity recognition model, which learns to identify and extract entities from unstructured user messages. A dialogue management component, also called core, is a so-called brain of your assistant. It makes a prediction of how an assistant should respond based on the specific state of the conversation as well as the context. Core learns by observing the patterns from example conversational data between the user and an assistant, also called stories. How Core keeps the context? Well, in short, a machine learning model under the hood takes into account quite a few details. It looks at what the conversation is currently about and also looks back at what has been said before. In addition to this, a dialogue management model may take into account some additional details, for example, the information extracted by the NLU model, because some entities, which can later be saved as slots, may have a direct influence on how a dialogue management model makes predictions. You will learn the details about this process in the later stages of the Rasa Masterclass. Last but not least, you need a mechanism which would allow your assistant to continue learning from real conversations. This technologically cumbersome task is made easier with RasaX, a tool which was specifically designed to make it easier for you to share your assistants with real users as soon as possible, collect the conversations they have with your assistant, then review those conversations, correct the mistakes, and use them to improve your assistant over time without interrupting the production process. So, to summarize, a natural language understanding component, NLU, enables your assistant to understand what the user says. A dialogue management component, Core, makes predictions on how an assistant should respond based on the specific state of the conversation and other details. And RasaX enables your assistant to continue learning from real conversational data. So all these Rasa components work together to empower you to build great contextual AI assistants that go far beyond simple FAQ interactions. So how do you start developing an AI assistant with Rasa? Well, there is a very simple and quick way to build your first Rasa-powered AI assistant with a Rasa CLI function called RasaInit. It automatically creates a Rasa project for you with some example training data and all of the most important project files that you would need to build any Rasa-powered AI assistant. Let's see how it all works in practice. After installing Rasa on your machine, open a terminal and run a command RasaInit. This command will create a new Rasa project in a local directory, which you can specify by providing a directory name. Let's call our directory RasaBot. Once a directory is initialized, Rasa will automatically fill this directory with the essential project files as well as some example training data and train the NLU and dialogue management models for you to test. RasaInit trains a simple assistant called MoodBot, which will ask you how you feel, and if you are unhappy, it will try to cheer you up by sending you a picture of a cute tiger cub. If you like, you can test this assistant immediately by having a conversation with it just after the models are trained. Let's give it a shot. I can start the conversation by saying hi. An assistant responds with, "Hey, how are you?" "Well, today I am a bit sad." An assistant understood that I am unhappy and sent me something to cheer me up. Let's check it out. Oh, that's cute. It definitely made me feel better. Using RasaInit is a great way to get a taste of how a Rasa-powered assistant works and what is required to build one. You can also use MoodBot as a basis of your own custom assistant. I would like to encourage you to spend more time playing around with MoodBot, test it on different inputs, and see how it performs. I will leave you to that for now, and I'll see you in the next episodes of the Rasa Masterclass, where we will dive even deeper into the development of our own contextual AI assistant with Rasa tools. Until next time.